Hi loves, Beth here, and today we're going to be talking about something that is so important for us as women, us as healers, and many of you are budding entrepreneuresses as well, and for all three of those categories, this topic is extremely important, and we're going to be talking about yin energy today. That's what's so important, like insanely important. Today's going to be a bit of a different video because part of the video I'm actually just going to be reading straight from this book, which has inspired so much of what's about to come out of me. It's called The Call to Power, The Grandmothers Speak, and it's essentially a book that is about one woman's journey, journeying through the upper worlds in a very shamanic sort of way to a group of women or a group of energies really who come as women, who come as grandmothers, and they call themselves the Council of Grandmothers, and there's 13 of them. It's very esoteric, this kind of work, but if you're chilling with me, you follow me, you're probably into it, because I am very esoteric and mystically minded. So I'm going to read a little bit to you from this book in a second here, but basically I wanted to talk about yin energy, and yin energy really it means feminine energy, right? And so few of us actually know what yin energy and feminine energy is. I like hang out with so many beautiful spiritual goddesses and women who are into this work and who are into, you know, their spiritual journeys. And still, I just look at all of us, you know, spiritual women, and I say, we're so still deficient in yin energy. We're so brainwashed by this society that says, let's do, let's produce, let's do more, let's work, let's hustle, let's make those lists. That's where our value comes from. That's where our worth comes from, is how much we can do and produce. That it just indicates to me, like, wow, we need to go so much deeper into yin energy in order to really harness it. Talking about feminine energy and yin energy is not something that you can just kind of say, like, oh, it's important to get feminine and get in your feminine side and put on that dress and be more like just sensual and flirty and get into your feminine. Like, that's like such small part of feminine energy that, you know, only works for some people. Feminine energy is yin energy, and yin energy is receptive energy. It's when we can pause. It's when we can just receive and rest and be both soft and strong. And I'll give you a few examples. If any of you wake up in the mornings and you feel like maybe you want to have a sleep-in day, or you're sleeping in a little bit on the weekends, and you know, this used to happen to me, and I know it's very common in a lot of us, you feel a sense of guilt. Like, oh, I shouldn't be sleeping in, I shouldn't be doing this, I should be doing stuff. I mean, there's, look at the day, it's sunny outside, I should be outside and like doing blah blah blah, or I should be getting on that to-do list or whatever it is. That's a huge sign that you're seriously deficient in yin energy. Yin is all about allowing us to rest and receive. Anybody who feels like, oh, I just like, I'm all about that list, I'm all about that to-do list, and like, what's next, always thinking ahead, what am I going to do next, and there's always just something else, and you're always kind of going in that direction, and you might actually like it and enjoy it in some ways, but you're always moving, you're always hustling, you are seriously deficient in yin energy, you know. And I'm just going to go straight to this book, because nobody can kind of talk about what I'm talking about better than the grandmothers. So, you know, you might not be able to understand fully every part of, you know, what I'm saying, because I didn't, you know, you haven't read the whole book, but whatever, you're going to get the gist of it. Okay. So, let's go for it. So yang, that indicates the masculine energy, right? Yang wants to build, to dig, delve, and acquire. This is its nature. It does not value trees for themselves, but views them as resources to be used for something else. Yang always asks the question, what are these good for? Forests stand for future buildings, lumber, and wealth. Yin is different, the grandmother said. Yin is the earth under and within the forest. It is the richness from which the forest springs. Yin doesn't build things, it grows them. It is the fertile place where everything grows. Yin is not about doing, because it is not its nature to do. The infusion of yin on the planet must start with women, they said. After all, it is women who grow and carry a child inside their bodies. This is patient work. This is yin. There is no doing necessary with the energy of yin, because most things grow without intervention. Once the seed is planted, growth proceeds on its own. Yang is good for change. It is needed to make change. It manufactures change and moves energy in a new direction. Okay, that's talking about something that you won't really understand. Okay, there is excitement and nervous energy in Yang, a high energy, the grandmother said. Yin is more relaxed. Yin is, they said, and I felt this quality of isness as my body expanded, spread deep and wide, and encompassed everything. Whatever I was at this moment was enormous and founded deeply in the earth. Yin is holding and fertile, the grandmother said. Yin goes on and on. A sensation of ease and connectedness filled me, a peace that would never end. Yang has a tendency to flash out and up. Its energy is active, they said. And inside me, I heard and felt buzz, blitz, and zip. What a shock after the steady influx of yin. So this woman who's talking was just meditating deeply on yin. These two couldn't have felt any more different. As the strident energy of yang built inside, I told myself, this is as it should be. We need both energies for a richer world. But as yang swelled, I no longer felt so philosophical. The grandmothers were giving me a taste of yang as it is today. Wild and out of control. It's boiling, I heard myself cry. It's coming on so fast. My body was shaking, almost convulsing with runaway energy. I could hardly bear the tension inside of me. Terrified, I cried, there's no rest in this. Grandmothers, help. Once again, the piece of yin descended, and as my body stopped quaking, I sobbed in relief. Yang needs yin for peace, they said. It needs a place to rest, and yin needs yang when it wants to change. The world has been yang for so long that it needs to be yin for a while. Everything is tired and needs the rest of yin. Is there anything else I want to... So just digest that while I see if there's anything else I... Okay, and the last thing I'll mention from this book. As a woman fills with the energy of yin, she affects all life around her. Everything benefits from a woman who holds this energy. As you fill with yin, you will feel good and you will see the effect you have on those in your lives. Everything, they said, men, animals, plants, and rocks will resonate and respond to you. All life needs this energy of nurturance and support. Looking hard at me, they said, you need it. Let yourself experience this infilling. Ask for the energy of yin to fill you. Seeking this for yourself is not a selfish act. This act blesses you and blesses all life. This, they said, is grace. Opening to yin is the most important thing a woman can do. With serious faces, they said, men cannot do this. They cannot help themselves receive the energy they so desperately need. But as you open to the feminine principle, men will automatically find relief. Gazing into my eyes, they said, for the good of everything that lives, we urge you to do this. So I've never really read from a book in one of my videos before, but like I said, that's powerful stuff. And this is just a section from this book. So if you're called to look more into this, it's called The Call to Power, The Grandmothers Speak by Sharon McIrlane. And so they said it pretty well, right? It's so important for us to infill with this energy of yin. And yin rests, okay? It's a really... I want you to ask yourself this question. Do you feel like if you stopped doing and acting and pursuing and striving, that nothing in your life would happen? And therefore, you need to strive. And therefore, you need to do in order to make things happen. Then, girlfriend, you are out of touch with your yin. And even I need to go much deeper into my yin. So that idea that only I am in control, I make life happen, you know, I make shit happen. And it's like the universe doesn't even exist in that realm, right? But honestly, if you kind of look at your life, and in some ways when I look at my life, like sometimes when I'm like most chilled out and most just like deeply into my rest and not doing very much, is when things kind of can happen for me. So it's this idea that when you're resting and when you're just letting go and in your yin, that you are going to be able to receive. I was in kind of this weird in-between space. I was having a nap maybe a week or two ago, kind of getting over this sickness that I just experienced. And I just felt the energy of my spirit guides and like my whale friends in the spirit world kind of was like super in between and just come over me. And they pointed so deeply to my root chakra, and I felt this really point of energy in my root chakra. And they were just showing me, without really words necessary, all you need to do is receive, right? In my business, I'm like making videos, doing emails, planning courses, following up with clients, you know, coming up with new stuff, finishing up old projects. And it's like I have it in my mind where I just need to keep doing and doing and doing. And that's where, like, that's how my business is going to grow. And like the book said, yin and yang, we need both. Yes, I do need to do some of that yang for sure. I do need to act and I do need to come from that place of inspired action. But what they showed me, my spirit guides and the beautiful whales that were chilling around me, is like, what you need more than anything is just to let it in, right? And we have a problem sometimes letting it in and receiving because sometimes we don't feel worthy enough and like we have to push to make it happen. But really, when we actually get and receive the energy, sometimes we can block it because we don't feel. So getting in your yin is a huge practice, and it's not something that's going to happen overnight, but it's going to bring more balance into our lives. And we do, as women, we need to rest, you know, so do men, but we need to rest. And any of you who are building businesses right now, you know, there's probably and likely way too much hustle going on, or way too much outward focus going on. You know, can you understand and can you open up to that there's this universal force that actually wants to just bring you abundance? You know, if we're ever feeling rushed, that's a sign that we're out of balance. There is, what this book also shows us, is there's no rush in nature. There's no rush in nature, okay? Things just flow as they're guided, and there's just this isness where we're not trying to get out of ourselves and be something that we're not. We actually can just rest in the fact that we are. We just are. We're everything. We're all of it. And, you know, times in my life when I can really connect with that are just the best times ever. So let's do a short meditation and just fill and allow the universe to fill us in with the yin. If you want more yin in your life, past this meditation, you can ask spirit, how can I be more yin? How can I bring more yin in? You can relax more. You can go slower. You can cross 5 of those things off your to-do list that are superfluous and don't really need to be done. You can connect with your soul in meditation and say, you know, what do you really want? You know, you can just hang out in the backyard and lie on the earth and be with a tree and connect with nature more and connect with plants more and just receive their energy. You know, we need to just be able to find these places of rest and relaxation, and so many of us can't because we feel guilt. Aren't I supposed to be doing something? Aren't I supposed to be productive? Sometimes, but more time, like we said, we need yin right now. We need so much yin. Okay, so let's just close your eyes with me and start to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. And all I want you to do is ask spirit and the council of grandmothers. I ask you to please infill my body and my energy body and my spirit with the energy of yin. And see this beautiful silver light coming through the top of your head, down your face, your neck, your shoulders, your heart, your chest, your torso, your arms, your stomach, your hips, your thighs, your knees, your calves, and your feet, and releasing through your feet, breathing this energy of the yin in. Allowing yourself to receive the energy of yin. It is time for us to go slower, realizing that in some ways, the slower we go, the more satisfaction we will find. Come back to center, come back to balance, come back to yin. Let us no longer deny the power of the goddess, the power of the feminine energy. It is safe to rest. It is safe to receive. We are worthy of receiving. The earth has everything that we could ever need. It's time for us to let go and allow that fact to come forth. Allowing the energy of yin and that silver light to move through you now. Whenever you're ready, you can wiggle your toes and open your eyes. So I want you to, over these next few days, really notice in your life where you're pushing, where you're striving, where you're hustling. And whenever you find yourself being in that energy in a way that doesn't feel right to you, in a way that feels, oh, I gotta do it, I gotta do it, I gotta get this, I gotta take a deep breath and challenge yourself to do this meditation, fill in with the yin, and ask, how can you bring more peace? How can you bring more rest? How can you bring more presence? How can you bring more release? And it might mean shutting off the computer and walking, going for a walk and just sitting in, on the beach for an hour. Or it might mean making a cup of tea and just sitting on your bed staring at the ceiling because that's what you need. Or it might mean going through with one of those tasks but not doing, you know, any more, and just kind of treating yourself with a bath or, you know, something that can bring you back to that moment of like, everything that we need and we desire is right in here. So let's stop with the craziness of constantly looking outside of ourselves. We need each other in order to do this. And we need each other in order to strengthen this yin energy. So may we honor the yin. It goes so much deeper than I could possibly explain in this video. And I'm still discovering so much of it myself. But in the yin, we find the Great Mother. In the Great Mother, we find unconditional love. And in unconditional love, we find absolute freedom and exactly what our world needs. So may this be so. May you be guided. May you be blessed. And may we together as women be a force for this yin energy. And may we bring that nurturing and that love and that essence that our men and our world so desperately need. Much love, sisters. And if you enjoyed this video, and if you're not a part of my Angel Coaching with Beth Katherine group, please join. I'm always posting new content videos to help, you know, healers, budding entrepreneuresses, and women that are walking the spiritual path. Yeah, just giving a lot of tips, insights, videos, free content, challenges, anything you name it. So all you need to do is search Angel Coaching with Beth Katherine, Katherine with a K, to find it. And if you're having some trouble, just search for Beth Katherine and like my Facebook page. And then on the top of it, it says, if you want to go deeper, come join this group. So hopefully you will have an easy time finding it for those who are interested in just staying in touch with me. Yeah, much love. We'll see you ladies soon.